All right. Okay. So welcome, everybody. We are going to get started here on your transitioning from dancing on one to dancing on two.
So great today. We have so many cool things planned. And remember this is a class about concept, okay? So what you really want to do is be listening to the concepts, understanding them, asking those kind of questions, and just focus on the big picture of what we're saying, and it will help your dancing, especially for those of you who are trying to transition or have been trying to transition.
Esta clase es dedicado a aquellos que han bailado en uno y quieren aprender a bailar más en dos. Es una manera que nosotros enseñamos para ayudar a esa transición de bailar en uno y en dos. Bienvenidos todos.
Okay, hi everyone. Hello. So, Nery and I are gonna lead this class today, the transition from dancing on one to dancing on two. This is one of my favorite things to talk about, to teach, and I know we're limited in time always, but it's all good. It's gonna be an awesome class. So please pay close attention to the concepts. Pay close attention to our movement, and ask those questions, okay? We're here to respond to the comments in the live chat, and then after this video is posted, remember, write it in there, and we will respond to you also in the fixed video, okay? The stage video on YouTube.
Si tienen preguntas, por favor, escríbenlo aquí para que se le puede contestar a aquellos que hablan español. Estamos tratando de dedicar esto también a los que hablan español. Bienvenidos a todos de todos Latinoamérica.
Hola. Okay, so the two main things we're going to be going over today, of course, the main differences between dancing on one and dancing on two, timing, body position, stuff like that. The physical, okay, which is the part I'm going to lead, and then the practical application, which is what Nery's going to lead. Okay, you've learned all this stuff. Now you know how to dance on two. Well, how do we find the beat properly, and what are we supposed to be listening for such that we're able to dance smoothly with the music and dance what we call within the music when dancing on two, okay, or dancing mambo. So what we're gonna do first, I just wanna go over some basic things about your basic step, salsa. Remember, we're doing our basic on one, and I just wanna preface right now, we're dancing on one, when we're dancing on one, we're dancing the shines timing or the lead timing. Okay, which is your 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So for today, everybody who's doing this, you want to be practicing that way. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, lo que está explicando Serena es que hoy vamos a bailar en dos también. Vamos a demostrar la diferencia en uno y en dos, pero ella va a marcar así los pasos de la mujer. Quiere decir que cuando uno está bailando en dos, tiene que marcar cuando va a hacer pasos libres enfrente. Y, pero yo voy a demostrar también cómo se baila con como los pasos de los hombres, de los guías.
And that I'm going to be leading the part about structure and the physical, and then Nery's going to be leading about the practical.
Okay. También vamos a, ella va a enseñar la parte de la estructura de cómo se baila el dos. Ese es estilo Nueva York, ¿tú dices?
Yes.
Estilo Nueva York, ella lo va a demostrar y después yo voy a guiar la parte de la, cómo se oye en la música.
Okay, and so when we're dancing on one, like I said, lead timing or shines timing. When we're dancing on two, we're dancing the shines timing, which happens to be the follows timing in New York style on two. So we're dancing 1, 2, 3, okay? So for both of us, when we're dancing on one or on two in this class today, 1, 2, 3, 4 is gonna be in the front half of our motion, the forward motion. Okay, whether it's 1, 2, 3, 4, or it's 1, 2, 3, 4, we're gonna be breaking forward on that, okay? So this should help you, hopefully. They're both shines timing. All right, now, when you're dancing on one, it's like, I really wanna explain to you about the big picture, the concept, right? The concept of dancing on one, which many of you must have heard, I'm sure you've heard, or maybe you teach this, and this is something how you teach. And if you don't, this is a great teaching tool for you to use. So please, it's for you. So what you want to know is that we're going outside of our center and we're returning to center as a concept. We're going outside of our center and returning to center. So you can see I'm on a piece of tape here. So outside of your center, return to the center. Same. Now it's the same if I step off the line, coming back to the line. Off the line, coming back line. Or here, I'm going side and together, side and together. So whatever happens, I'm home base. I'm like the center, right, of myself. Now, I'm gonna step. We always use a reference of a clock as well, right? So I'm gonna step 12 o'clock, center. 6 o'clock, center. 12 o'clock, center. 6 o'clock, center. Now you can see the same thing sideways, yeah? 12 o'clock, center. 6 o'clock, center.
Ella está usando ahorita como un reloj. Ella está marcando, cuando marca enfrente es como marcar a las 12 de la tarde. Y cuando marca para atrás son las 6 de la tarde.
Okay, so you can see though that I'm not executing a full stop. This is not the intention. The intention is not forward and together and lock. It's not that way.
La intención no es marcar para enfrente y después parar en el centro. Así no se baila el 12.
The purpose is that, you know, we're dancing. We have momentum. Okay, so our center step or our collection step is not like glued together. It's a little bit of a walk, but our pause is located at that position on count four. The pause is really count three and includes count four, but it begins on the three.
Ahora, lo más importante es que ella está pasando los pies. No está llegando al centro, pero sí hay una colección, pero pasando y agarrando la energía para seguir pasando los pies.
So how I'm moving right now is for somebody who's dancing on one. This is visually what it would look like. A rock step, a collection. A rock step and a collection. Now, remember, not collection like stuck. Collection like in comparison to the rock step, our feet are more together.
Ella está aquí explicando cómo se ve bailando en uno, que si ven que en el centro ella llega a una colección. En el 2 no es así. Ella va a pasar los pies.
So for those of you who already dance on one, you're like, I don't need to know this. I already dance on one. This is, you have to understand the concepts behind dancing on one in order to understand the concepts behind dancing on two to make your transition super smooth.
Es bien importante que si saben ya bailar en uno, que dicen, no, yo ya sé bailar en uno. Es importante saber la diferencia en cómo se ve bailar en uno a comparado en dos.
Okay, so now let's talk about dancing on two.
Vamos a hablar de cómo se bailan en el dos.
Now, dancing on two. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna do just our basic step. Now, we're gonna step in place or slightly forward on the one with the right foot. One, rock step, two, three, back five, six, seven. So remember the front half of our basic has a forward action. You know, the front half has that forward push. One, two, three. And we're also pushing back. You know, it's the same as when I was over here dancing on one. But what's different about this is where the pause is located.
Es bien importante que la energía que ella está marcando para enfrente, si lo contamos, vamos, Serena, can we start with the count on
yeah.
1, 2, 3, but in Spanish?
Yeah. So, 1, 2, 3.
Ahí es donde uno para cuando era la diferencia antes en la colección en el 1. Ahora esta es la colección en el 2.
So, first, let's focus on that. So, 1, 2, 3. Right here is where our pause is located. Okay, so for your pause, it's not where you collect the feet. It's actually in a split weight position. So, excuse me, split leg position. Your weight is still on your right foot. Okay, your weight is still on your right, on your three. But your feet are not in a collected position. Your weight's on your right and your left foot's in front. So what we're doing is 1, 2, 3. And here's your pause. What happens when we're dancing on two is we dance, or excuse me, walk through the pause. We're walking through the pause here. So we're going one, two, three, and we're gonna walk through this pause on four. Drag that foot, but don't put weight until five. Then we finish our basics, six, seven.
La diferencia en esto es que cuando ella está marcando uno, dos, tres, el movimiento sigue en el cuatro, no hay pausas, cuatro, pero no hay peso hasta que llegue al cinco en el pie izquierdo. Después derecho, seis, siete.
Okay. Now, there's many, many styles when you're dancing on two that have a push forward on six, seven, or that have a push back on two, three. Some push forward, some push back. So today, we're not going to talk about those. Today, we're just talking about transitioning your timing. To go deeper into all the styles of dancing on two, Puerto Rican style, New York style, like have it be like super mambo style. You know, there's just so many beautiful variations of on two. Like, I love it. It's my passion. Okay, so for now, what you want to understand is the timing difference. And with timing comes the location of the pause.
Ella entiende que hay muchos estilos de bailar en dos, Nueva York, el estilo puertorriqueño, pero lo que vamos a entender hoy es cómo solo marcar simplemente el paso del dos a comparado al paso del uno y cómo podemos escuchar eso y ver la diferencia en los pies.
So what you can see here is that I'm changing my weight, but my pause is immediately after the step of my rock step. We've all heard the term rock step, yeah? So after you execute rock step, that's your pause in that moment. It's your three, or in this case, the other side is your step. So watch. We're gonna go one, two, three, five, six, seven. So this way, we're going one, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, pause, five, six, pause, walk. Two, pause, walk. Six, pause, walk, rock, step. The way that I love to teach this is walk, rock, step.
La manera que ella le gusta, I don't know how to say rock step in Spanish, but forgive me
step.
For that.
You gotta look up
that. Rock step. Pero so, realmente es,
Camina.
Caminando.
Y rock y paso.
Si sí, ven lo que ella está haciendo, es un cambio de paso, pero lo está haciendo en el 2, 3.
So, 1, 2, 3. Walk, rock, step. Walk, rock, step. Walk, rock, step. Walk, rock, step. Now let's take a look at dancing on one. Let's go back. When you're dancing on one, we have rock, step, walk. Rock, step, walk.
Bailando en uno,
rock, step,
es al revés. Walk.
Rock,
step, está al principio.
Rock, step,
y caminando.
Rock, step, walk. And on your walk is your pause. Okay, in this case, on your step is your pause. Okay, now some people may say, you may say, walk, rock, step is confusing. No worries. So another analogy that hopefully this helps you is quick, quick, slow. Many people teach with quick, quick, slow. Many ballrooms teach with quick, quick, slow. Many salseros teach quick, quick, slow. So we're gonna do this side by side, Nery and I, in just a minute. Now first, I wanna demonstrate for you both. Quick, quick, slow. What does that even mean? Okay. Quick, quick, and then slow.
Ella va a indicar ahora, va a explicar qué significa lo que ella está diciendo, que es rápido, rápido, despacio.
Sí. Okay. The despacio, the slow, represents two beats. We're talking about four beats here. And if you were in my music class last Thursday, this will make much more sense to you as well. So we're talking about quick, quick, slow. Slow gets two beats. We're talking about one, we're talking about two, we're talking about three, and then we're talking about four as well.
Estamos hablando de una vara de música. Si se han metido en las clases anteriormente, es que en una vara de música hay cuatro latidos. Pero cuando uno está bailando en el dos, hay una pausa con dos látigos. Quiere decir que vamos a ir uno, dos, y vamos a descansar en los últimos dos.
Okay, so this is from my class last Thursday. So hopefully, can you turn that around for me?
Sí.
So hopefully this helps you out. And I'm not sure about the angle, yeah. But here's your bar. We are talking about quick, quick, slow. Okay, the slow, the three is your slow when you're dancing on, let's say, dancing on one or dancing on two. It does not matter. Quick, quick, slow es lo mismo. Quick, quick, slow. It's always one, two, three. Now let me demonstrate for you.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna do it side by side.
Y después con música.
Nery's gonna dance on one. All right.
On one.
En
el uno voy a bailar.
I was demonstrating on one on this side of the room. I was demonstrating on two on this side of the room. We're gonna keep that integrity. This is on one. Hello, on one.
Hello.
And I am on two. Hello. Okay. So when we do this, we're gonna do our basics forward and back, and we're gonna do our side basic. Okay. So let's do. When we do our forward and back basic, we'll face the diagonal, so you can see clearly where our pause is located. And then when we do our side basic, we'll face the back, so you can see clearly where our pause is located.
Lo que vamos a hacer ahorita, yo voy a bailar en uno, ella va a bailar en dos. Yo voy a hacer el mismo tiempo para marcar los pasos libres que es en el paso de los hombres. Ahora, vamos a mostrar de diferentes ángulos cómo vamos a bailar en este lado y después lo vamos a hacer de este lado para que lo hagamos de un básico pero largo. Y van a notar la diferencia a dónde van a ser las pausas en el uno comparado al dos.
Okay. So remember, now we're talking about quick, quick, slow here. So let's do first counts, mm-hmm. And then quick, quick, slow. So let's do our basic.
Okay.
So remember, I'm just counting counts. He's going to dance on one, I'm going to dance on two. ¿Listo?
I'm ready.
Bueno. 5, 6, 7, we're going. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. On 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. I'm on 2, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, let's slow down. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow for two beats. Quick, quick, slow for two beats. Quick, quick, slow for two beats. Now we're gonna move our basic to the side step. Here we go. And quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now, hopefully that is an excellent demonstration for you to see your basic step on one and on two. También, your side basic on one and on two. Now you wanna remember, this can be so much, okay? So when you're transitioning from on one to on two, it's actually most important that you focus on your body positioning. Don't worry so much about style. Oh, on two is said to be more flowy. People say it's more difficult. People say I can do more spins. On one is supposed to be more sharp, more flashy, better for tricks. Don't worry about what people say or what style and all those things. Step one is know the counts and know where your body is supposed to go. ¿Y en español?
Hola, hola. Okay.
So, lo más importante es que saber que yo sé que muchos instructores dicen, el 2 es mejor en esto, o el 1 es mejor en esto. No, no ponga atención a eso. Realmente este es el momento para ver para uno mismo lo que uno puede descubrir de uno mismo cómo uno siente el 1 comparado al 2. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, so the most important thing is that you focus on your body position and your timing. Okay, watch this. That part of the video over and over and over is muy importante to see the difference in where the pause is located. And this, there are really three parts to this, okay? There is the understanding the concepts, like I demonstrated. There's what we're about to do next, which is the application. Now, how do you hear music and decide what you're gonna do? Okay, that's the next part. And then lastly, really, which we're not covering today, we'll have to do it in the future, is really distinguishing the different styles of On1 and the different styles of On2. I like to think of those as like dialects of English, right? Like someone from England may sound different than someone, or definitely sound different than someone like from New York City, or different than someone from Australia, and so on. So you have, we're all speaking English, but it's different dialects, same with Spanish. So we're all doing the same thing. It just has a different style and a different, it doesn't make one better than the other. They're just different, and it gives variety to your dancing, and it's a different way to express yourself within the music.
Lo que Serena está explicando es que en realidad hay muchos diferentes estilos en cómo bailar el 1 y también en el 2. Por favor, no se pongan mucho en el estilo, pero mejor en la técnica de cómo en realidad bailar el 2 comparado al 1.
And the language. And how it's like a language, there's different dialects of that.
Ah, sí, es como un lenguaje que hay muchos dialécticos y todos hablamos. Digamos, por ejemplo, el español en diferentes países se usan diferentes palabras y es igual con esto del 1 y el 2. No quiere significar que uno es mejor que el otro.
Okay, and I just want to give you one more piece of physical before we move into Nery's portion. So we're just going to do a basic right turn, which I think is very helpful for people who are transitioning. It gives you something more to practice than just the basic, right? We have our basic, we have our side basic, and then we'll do our right turn dancing on two.
We'll do it all to music, don't worry. Lo vamos a hacer con música después.
And we're going to do the right turn.
Vamos a hacer, ahora ella va a enseñar cómo dar una vuelta al lado derecho con, bailando en dos.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 5. You're still step 12 o'clock. 1, 2, 3. Now my 5 is going to be behind myself, and I'm going to push backwards, right? 5, 6, 7. So one, let me do it this way for you guys. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Walk, rock, step, walk, rock, step, walk, rock, step. Here we go. 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So your homework would be to be able to do the basic shines or the basic moves that you can already do on one. And try them out to dancing on two.
Lo bonito de esto es que ella quiere que si ya saben hacer una derecha en uno, ahora lo pueden probar tratando en el dos. Y yo sé que se va a sentir medio raro, no se va a sentir normal, pero tienen que practicar para mejorar.
And remember, the location of the pause is everything. The location of the pause is really, really, really what distinguishes the difference between dancing on one and dancing on two.
Ella quiere otra vez decirle que a donde la pausa va a caer es lo que hace la diferencia bailando en uno y en dos. Es bien importante cuando uno baila en dos, tiene que saber cuándo va a ser la pausa comparada al uno.
And a good dancer or a person who is doing this proficiently, like they know what they're doing, and they're intentional about it, they're able to, you should be able to put a video of them on mute and see and be able to tell if that person is dancing on one with their proper on one technique or they're dancing on two with their appropriate on two technique for their style.
Serena dice que lo mejor que uno puede hacer a veces cuando uno ve un video, si uno puede saber que una persona está bailando la técnica propia en dos, cuando uno puede ponerle la música en cero volumen y ver la técnica del bailarín. Si el bailarín está mostrando que está bailando en dos, eso significa que sí, en realidad, está haciendo la técnica al dos, okay. Sin la música.
So, that's that. I hope that helps you at least begin the transition. I know this is a class that everybody wants, so we just wanted to get it out there and be sharing it. So if you like it, remember this is not the end. This is the end of this first section. Nery's about to come on right now. But if you like it, write in the comments that you'd like to see more of this, and we'll do more transitional classes, and that should help you actually convert your dancing much faster than trying to do it all by yourself. Y Nery Antonio.
Cambiamos.
Okay.
So now I'm going to do the part of the application of how we're going to incorporate all this. And I'm gonna show you how I, dancing on one for many years, I wanna say I danced on one for 12 years before I start even touching the two. And I'm gonna give you some tips on how it helped me from other teachers. And so if it works for you, great. But again, this is something that worked for me, and I just wanna pass it along to all of you. Ahora, check, bienvenidos. Estoy aquí porque les quiero enseñar la técnica de que cómo podemos cambiar del 1 al 2. Ahora, estas son cosas que yo aprendí. Yo bailé salsa en 1 por 12 años sin tocar el 2. 12 años sin aprender el 2. Todo era en 1. Y tuve muchos instructores que me ayudaron a hacer diferentes prácticas para yo seguir practicando y entender cómo trabajaba esto del 2. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you a phrase, a teacher of mine. I don't know how many of you remember a great teacher by the name of Edie, the salsa freak.
Woo woo.
Edie Lewis. She is the reason why I am here. This is a woman that started dancing LA style back in the 90s and took it to Europe and had a great way of teaching things. And one important thing is, when you're dancing on two, okay, you must apply it and practice it as much as you can, in the sense that if you're trying to do it, go into a club, and if you're gonna dance a song on one, try the next one on two. And keep that balance going until you start transferring little over and over until you feel more comfortable. Lo más importante que voy a explicar ahora es que yo tuve una profesora que se llama Edie, the Salsa Freak. No sé si ustedes se recuerdan de ella. Ella me ayudó mucho en cómo escuchar el 2, porque a mí me costó mucho encontrar el 1 y ahora tengo que bailar en 2. Uf, un dilema bien grande. Pero lo que les quiero decir es que lo más importante es que practiquen. Si están bailando mucho en 1, yo bailé 12 años solamente en 1, poco a poco, cuando salgan a bailar, bailen una canción en 1 y después la otra en 2. Y después otra vez en 1 y después la otra en 2. Y poco a poco, súbenle. Tienen que crecer con esa confianza que pueden bailar en 2. Alright. So, I want you to understand this phrase, and I've been using this phrase since Edie taught it to me. And it's in Spanish. It's called café con pan, which means coffee with bread. Es una frase que mi profesora me enseñó, que me dice, Nery, di esta frase. Café con pan.
Yeah.
¿Qué quieres de desayuno? Café con pan. What do you want for breakfast? Café con pan. Coffee with bread. So when you're dancing on one, everybody's saying, oh, you're dancing on the beat, on top of the music. And it's true. I truly feel that when you dance on one, you're dancing on top of the music. When you're dancing on two, you're actually dancing within the music. Let me explain myself. Una cosa que siempre dicen de bailar en uno a comparado al dos es que cuando uno está bailando en el uno, estamos bailando encima de la música, encima del látigo. Ahora, cuando uno está bailando en uno, estamos bailando encima de la música. Cuando estamos bailando en dos, estamos bailando adentro de la música. Vamos a hablar de eso después, pero hagamos esto. Café con pan. Café con pan. Café con pan. If my mother asked me, what do you want for breakfast? Café con pan. I'll be café con pan. Café is my one. So what do you want for breakfast, Nery? Café con pan. Café con pan. Café. I'm telling her I want it on that coffee. I want coffee. Coffee is what I want, and I want bread. But if I were to dance on two, let's say I'm going to do the shine, I'll be, what do you want for breakfast, Nery? Café con pan. 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 So for me, the con gives me that moment to think, to say, what else do I want? I want bread. So that's why it feels as if we have more time. That's what everybody says. Oh, I feel I have more time. And even in that phrase, you're saying, I want coffee with bread. Coffee with bread. So you're constantly telling your audience, or you're telling your partner where you're at in that thought. En español, cuando digo esa frase, café con pan, es bien importante porque si mi mamá me pregunta, Nere, ¿qué quieres para desayunar? Café con pan. Café es el acento que tengo. Por eso cuando bailo en uno, es como le estoy diciendo, quiero café, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café. Y pueden oír ese café. Pero si bailo en el dos, y me preguntan otra vez, Nery, ¿qué quieres para desayunar? Café con pan, 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 café con pan. Now, if I were to dance on three, okay, believe it or not, son, S-O-N, we'll talk about this in the future. Yes, you can dance on three. Now, if I were to dance on three, it would sound like this. If I were to dance it, and let's say I mark forward on the three. Café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan. To me, it feels I have an eternity to step into that step. It's weird, but try it. Try it at home. Traten marcando en el pan. Café con pan, café con pan, café con pan. Siento que tengo una eternidad para marcar ese pan o el 3 en 7. Now, it's crazy, but it's something that it really helped me transition into that. Now, how can you do that with a partner? Okay? Again, you can use a chair, but since I have Serena Cuevas, I'm going to choose Serena. Okay, in my brain, okay, we'll talk about music. We haven't touched music yet. If I'm here, okay, and I want to do on one, café con pan, 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 café con pan. You're saying, man, I want that coffee, right? But if I'm dancing on two, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan. It sounds like I'm not so much into like, I want coffee. No, you're taking your time saying, hey, I want coffee and bread, okay? So again, these are things that you can see the difference. Pueden notar la diferencia en eso, en solo esa frase, café con pan. Y les digo, aprendí esa frase y siempre se me ha quedado conmigo, okay?
And remember that café con pan,
so todos, café con pan, ok? Vamos a probar con música,
ok?
Before we start with the music, I have it on the iPad, we're going to use, there's an app called Salsa Rhythm. Hay una aplicación, lo podemos traer aquí, se llama, no sé si lo pueden ver cerquita, se llama Salsa Rhythm. Es una aplicación que hay en Apple y también en Android. Es una aplicación que hay diferentes instrumentos que vamos a oír. Ahora, yo fui a Puerto Rico hace años y yo estaba bailando en uno. Now, I went to Puerto Rico and I was dancing on one and this guy looks at me and he says, what are you doing? And I said, oh, I'm dancing LA style, I'm one, you know? And he looked at me like I was like from another planet because he goes, brother, you're not feeling the music. And I said, what? What? I said, I can find the beat. Café! Café!
That's so, my teacher.
So, right? So, it, para mí, yo cuando fui a Puerto Rico, un muchacho me dice, ¿qué están bailando? Y digo, el uno, aquí estoy bailando en el uno. Y me dice, no, tú no estás sintiendo la música. Y le digo, ¿por qué? Si estoy contando y estoy marcando el uno. Y realmente, lo que él quería explicarme es que hay una parte en la música que se llama el tumbao, which is, tumbao is by the congas. Tum-tum, pa, tum-tum, pa. And I'm going to play this, and you're going to see at home, I want you to see the difference if I were to dance. And so Serena eventually is going to come up here. She's going to dance it on two, and I'm going to dance it on one just to the tumbao, which is the congas, which to us, clave is the heart of salsa, okay? The two sticks, claves, right? Creating the clave beat.
And tumbao is the blood. So it's the blood that makes everything go, okay? If I can play that app, I'm gonna use this. And so on here, okay, and I don't know if the glare is gonna bother you. Can I see in the screen? Yes. So in here, okay, let me move it up just a little bit because of the screen. Okay, anyways.
Tilt it down.
Yeah, there you go. And you tilt it down.
Perfect. Okay, tumbao is right here. You see the two drums right here? And I'm gonna hit that, okay, on my play. And let's see if it plays. I'll turn it on. Okay. So using that, boom, boom, ba, boom, boom, ba. You're gonna hear this flat. Ba. So my friend from Puerto Rico, mi amigo de Puerto Rico, me dice, Nery, escucha. He goes, I'm not counting, I'm feeling. What he's feeling is the slap. This is called a simple tumbao. Now, I dance on one, it doesn't really make sense. It's even harder. 5, 6, 7. If you notice, I'm dancing on one. See that, but my café is not being heard. My one's not being heard, but my two, con, is there telling me. Now, if I bring Serena, Serena's gonna do on two, and I'm gonna do one, so you can see the difference. If we do a side basic, Serena, Serena. Ella está marcando en el pa. Ahora. Okay.
It's gonna take you guys into another round.
El cha-cha-cha, which cha-cha you dance only on the? Por favor, because it was written that way. Esta aplicación, this application that I just used is awesome because what was happening is you must have heard another instrument in there. It wasn't just the tumbao, it was also the bass. Había otro instrumento que estábamos tocando ahí y al final se lo quité. It's very important that you listen, that you, I mean, this is so cool. I wish I would have had this application 12 years ago so I can learn. But this is really cool because you can actually put the type of tumbao. See here, if we can see that, there's a tumbao. We have the simple, and you can see that I can... Yes. Ahora, café con pan. Café, café, café con pan. Café con pan. Now, if I bring Serena over, and I'm going to practice. You know how hard this could be for you? Only if you listen. Café, con. Café, compa, café, compa, café. Crossbody leads, all the same. Café, compa, café, compa, café, café, café. Say it. You must say it so it happens. Two, three, six, seven. Café, café, compa. Now the turn. If I go. So all of the moves that we've been using in On1 shouldn't be a problem, except now we have to understand that we must count even more and be more connected to the music, okay?
Because now you're relocating where the slow physically is. It's very important. So you need to know, gentlemen, like one of you mentioned, that must mean when you're turning her, she has more time. That's true. Which then leads for what? Exactly what you said. More spins or more styling opportunity or more variation. Super true. So you have to know your counts. When you're someone who's transitioning and you're already in the world of counts, counting on one, counting on one, and now you want to count on two, you got to be counting. You got to know where things are located so you know exactly how to lead me. You know exactly how fast and how slow to go, just like shifting gears when you're driving. You need to be in the right gear so you know what to give me so I can provide it at the right speed.
Let's try an exercise. This is really cool. I would do this sometimes. I would look at a social dance on YouTube and turn the volume off and see if I can understand what count they were dancing on.
Great.
And I want to put a song on. It's called Perdóname by Gilberto Santa Rosa. And I want us to make sure that we can listen and see if we want to dance, if we're dancing on one, if we're dancing on two. It's very important. So on Spotify, I have it set. Mm-hmm. We're going to now try and dance together and see. I'm not going to tell you if I'm dancing on one or dancing on two. You're going to have to guess for yourself.
All right, let's do it.
Hago un llamado a tu conciencia. La mía ya me está matando. Quien te está hablando se rindió, perdió todas sus fuerzas y hoy viene a suplicarte y a pedir perdón. Quiero que sepas que he cambiado, que estar sin ti ha sido amargo.
Always a pleasure dancing with this young lady. This song, Perdóname, was one of the songs that I had to train my ear to hear the café con pan in it. So if you like, that's a great song. Serena will type in the name of that song. It's called Perdóname. And esta es una canción que usé, que utilicé mucho para acomodarme más al dos. Y esta canción en realidad me ayudó mucho a practicar, practicar, practicar. Quería que vieran esos bailes para ver si pueden saber cuál era cuando estábamos bailando en el uno y cuando estábamos bailando en el dos. I just wanted to do that to see if you guys can see which one was when we were dancing on one and when we switched to on two. Yes.
And
And they can see, and everybody was like, two, and now one, and now two.
Any cafes, compan? I'm hungry.
Well, just ones and twos, which is good. What's up, Mike? Yes.
Is that my cousin? Mike Bicelli, on to King.
Okay, awesome. Anything else you want to add?
I just, you know, these are just things that for myself, Serena, you did a beautiful job explaining the footwork. Remember, I do want to remind everybody that, gentlemen, when you're dancing on two, yes, I know we dance forward on one, but when we dance on two facing the lady, we do change our footwork. One, two, three, five, six, seven. We are receiving instead of just going at it at first. And so this is actually really nice. It's almost like taking care of and saying, come to me. That's how I like to picture it. When dancing on two, you're saying, come to me. On one, it's like, let me come to you, you know? Okay.
And they asked about what the name of the app is. So the app is called Salsa Rhythm, and I added it into the chat there. Also the name of the song, Perdóname, by Gilberto Santa Rosa. So that's all in there. And thank you so much. Like French Vanilla, I love your comment.
French Vanilla, says, always on.
This is exactly the breakdown I needed. I took about 5 classes for On2 and I would still struggle, sad face.
I've been there.
I totally get it. And Cafe Con Pan has just changed the game for me. I think I finally got the flow of On2.
Well, we can thank Edie, the salsa freak,
That's
for
right.
that.
Gracias a Edie.
Gracias a Edie.
Yes, everybody, thank you. I see the difference. Okay, good, good. And they can visually see the difference when we're dancing.
Nice.
The man always starts backwards on the one. Yeah, yes, Walker. So your one, when you're dancing on two, it's considered in place or underneath yourself, but it does move you backwards. So you're going to step one, then two, three, five, six, seven. So your one is on your way back. That's correct. Okay, very nice, very nice. All right, good to go. You're welcome, everybody, for the class.
Please make sure to share. Again, we're doing these classes because I know this is a difficult time for a lot of people. As even though we're getting deep in this, you know, we don't know how much longer here in the United States we're going to be in this situation. We don't know in Europe, en Europa no sabemos cómo está la crisis y cuánto vamos a durar, pero estamos felices que podemos estar con ustedes, siempre dándoles una clasecita y a ver si aprenden algo. Y por favor, si lo pueden compartir con toda la gente, realmente Serena Cuevas tiene su estudio aquí en San Diego, California. Yo estoy aquí ayudando y trabajando con ella, pero realmente, you know, the situation is, yes, this is a beautiful studio. As you can see, it's closed. There's no work, but we are glad to be here working with all of you and sharing our knowledge as much as we can while we can.
Yeah.
And so thank you again.
Yeah. And I also want to say this class it really sisters up beautifully with our music class that was last Thursday. So take a look in the list of classes that Nery has, and there's one called Finding the One. It's called Finding the One, Intro to Musicality. And this Thursday, 2 days from today, we are doing the same, but part two. It's Finding the One, but Intro to Music. Now, we did, I showed you the board earlier, and that was a little bit from that class, and we're taking it even deeper, so please do just watch that video from Thursday. Again, it's called Finding the One, Intro to Musicality. And then that will help this so much, because if you can deeply, truly, quickly, like with, you know, 10 out of 10 every time, find the one, it doesn't matter if you're dancing on one or on two. You found where to start, whether you're starting one, two, three, or you're starting one, two, three. So you got to be able to find the one to dance, period. So please watch that video and then follow us again to watch again on Thursday, because Thursday is going to be amazing.
Este jueves vamos a tener otra clase, Encontrando el Uno, y es parte 2 de eso. Y si les gustó lo que estamos enseñando ahora, es bien importante que por favor tomen esa clase este jueves, porque es una explicación de cómo la música tiene su estructura y a la misma vez vamos a hablar cómo sube y baja la música, a dónde está los cortes y todo. Es bien importante. Este jueves, gracias otra vez a todos, tenemos otra clase que sigue, que es merengue. Y merengue es el rey de todo porque es lo que nos enseña a bailar salsa. I'd like to say thank you very much to everybody. Again, if you guys can donate, we're talking about nokidhungry.org. It's very important. That's a charity that we're working with that are feeding kids on how to, in this crisis right now, it's called nokidhungry.org. And you can give donations. These are kids that really were getting their meals at school. And since there's no school, now they're not getting food. So please, if you can look into that, it'd be great. To give, if you can, $1 or $5, it feeds these kids, and that's why we're also pushing these classes to also promote positive stuff out there in the world.
Help people.
I know, we gotta help them. We gotta help them. So, gracias a todos. Nos vemos prontos. Se me cuidan. Take care, everybody. See you in a few minutes.